Apparently, Grandpa just gives me the remote after we watch the Powerball. Apparently, you're spinning around, and apparently every time you get dizzy.
And apparently, this is the cutest kid in the world. Oh. And apparently, he loves to go to the fair.
Hey, it's
and apparently, he loves... He just loves everything in the world.
Apparently.
He is making the rounds on social media, also making his national TV debut. He was on ABC, featured him yesterday on World News.
Yeah.
He's just burning up Facebook and Twitter and social media. He's a whole lot of fun. You
gotta apparently he's everywhere.
He says apparently, I don't know how many times, apparently like 100. He's hilarious. He's the funniest little kid ever. You gotta check this kid out because he will certainly make you laugh.
Apparently,
he certainly is.
Natural.
Apparently, we all need to watch out for our jobs because he's coming for him.
Apparently.
Because it's good stuff there.
We love this too. Apparently, we are celebrating in big ways here this morning. I gotta kind of jump out of the view of the camera here because this here, I think this belongs on Kellie's Kellie's head for the duration of.
I think it
of
does.
Little bit of a.
It's my crown.
Pinterest buddy here this morning. Good morning. Welcome back.
Covered up, Shirley.
Yeah, we had Sarah here, a balloon artist, creating these masterpieces. Hard to believe this is even a balloon. I mean, I'm just trying to get it closer to the camera. I'm putting it back on. You look at it from far away, it could look like anything. But when you see, I mean, how many balloons goes into something like this?
Oh, around 50.
Wow.
Well, how much time goes into something like this?
A couple hours. Like, once you get used to it.
Couple hours.
Now, is this something that you just kind of like, you can put the TV on and just kind of go for it? You just kind of are such a natural
it's
at
like
it?
Like your version of knitting.
Yeah.
Just in front of the TV, just making balloons.
And I mean, look, this is taller than Max. And Max, you're
a tall
guy.
Person.
So, I mean.
I'm curious, you know, there's a cool, like a flower looking balloon there, a little yellow center. How, like a balloon like that, how do you put it together?
A
little secret.
Really?
Some of those are little shapes, or is it multiple balloons in there?
Oh, yes, definitely.
Okay.
Each one has several balloons added to
it. Oh, that one's cool.
Okay.
Yeah.
Now, is there anything you can't do? I was checking out your website earlier. It looks like you were making, like, hula dancers. You were making everything out of a balloon.
Yes, I love to make anything, so throw it at me, and I'll try it.
You just like to accept that challenge.
Yes,
that's very brave.
How about a small little balloon BMW?
I
think
you have to turn like this.
I got to turn
you have to turn your
I'm like the Queen of England.
Awesome.
Been having too much fun with the hats and all that.
Now, the best part about the cake is that it's fat-free.
Hey! There we go. We need that's what we need a big sticker on there saying.
Fat-free.
You know, it's a nice little hobby. It seems like something you were mentioning earlier that, you know, you have some kids. And mm-hmm. I mean, is this a fun activity that you enjoy doing with them that other parents may find?
Yes. My 7-year-old already knows 8 different balloon shapes. He loves it. I'll bring him to the parties, and he'll make balloons for the kids.
Mm-hmm. Kind of starting the career off.
There you go. Now, you two, when you were giving us some of the balloons to try to recreate our own, they weren't great. They weren't pros.
Hey,
like,
speak for yourself. That looked fantastic.
He yelled and jumped and scared me, so that's why my attention was just not focused.
There's no other reason why I wasn't.
But you were just using air. Is there a difference between using...
Did it work that time? Yeah, it worked again.
Between using helium or between using just air?
Well, there is. The helium's a little more expensive, and only the round balloons will usually float.
Huh.
So I try to use the air more than the helium just because it's better for the environment and it's a little more cost efficient.
And this one would float off her head if it was
helium. Yeah, exactly. I'd be like up, remember? And up he floats away with all the balloons.
Are you
going to
be showing us something? Are you holding the balloon for?
So this is called a balloon cluster, and it's a lot of fun. I use them. I hang them from ceilings.
Oh, cute.
Cool.
Gazebos, things like that, and they're actually really easy to use.
It's kind of like a little balloon chandelier here.
Yeah.
Like that.
Yes, exactly.
So now, do you just tie them all together in the inside there?
That's right. I can show you how. It's really easy.
Yeah, I'm kind of curious how you get in the middle of it.
We don't have a ton of time, but.
So no problem. So
she's quick.
Quickly.
The main key to this is to have all the balloons the same size.
Okay.
And I like to underinflate them about halfway so that they're nice and soft.
Okay.
And they last longer that way.
Okay.
So we take 2 balloons. And we twist them, and then we tie them.
Just kind of do the little roll around there.
It's that easy. It's just that easy. I'm sure.
But I was surprised at how pliable they were.
Well,
yeah,
these ones maybe not as much.
That's why we underinflate them.
Oh,
looking fantastic there.
Hey, good tips for us on this second cup. Looking fabulous. Thank you so much, Sarah. The balloon master says, "Have a good day." Oh, look at it bounce.
Easily distracted there.